forever. We'll do a picture and we'll do a picture here too. But if you could just grab a seat for 1 second, everybody, so we could bemet continue the davening through words of tefillah. And if you do have your booklets, if you could open up, please, to page. Please open up. On page 32. Page 32. This is just a sweet gem. Really a sweet gem. And everyone's trying to understand what was the chiddush of the Baal Shem Tov. What did he really do? What was different? What was before the Baal Shem Tov? And what's the world after the Baal Shem Tov? And it's very difficult to put in words something that the Neshama understands. But we'll try, we'll use the words of a great tzaddik who is alive right now in Eretz Yisrael, and that's Rav Kluger. Those of you that have heard of Rav Kluger, the Gadol. And his ability to illustrate verbally what many of us feel is really a wonder. Bichlal, whenever you're able to do that on any level, it's very special. So I found a small piece that I saw that my Rebbe Rav Weinberger taught. I just typed up the pieces that I thought were relevant for us to understand what was the chiddush of the Baal Shem Tov. I believe that these words are tremendous, tremendous physic for us. So open your hearts, or continue to just widen your hearts, because you can smell it, that it's already open. And let's see Rav Kluger says, Rav Adam Tzvi Kluger, on page 32. Ma pala Baal Shem Tov HaKadosh Babriya, what did the Baal Shem Tov do in the creation? What was the chiddush here? Ki kodem lachen, dibru tamid al shifl sa'adam. Before the Baal Shem Tov, when you'd have someone that would try to awaken you, so it would speak, the person would speak mainly about how low man is and how small and little man is. That is the manner in which people would awaken you. Umeaz va'elach hechelu medavrin migadlu savai. But, Rav Kluger says, the Baal Shem Tov changed the focus of how you awaken you. If before, the point was to make a Jew realize that he's so little, now Baal Shem Tov says, let's stop focusing on that. Let's put the focus on how big Hashem is. You understand how big of a difference that is? It's the same thing, meaning it's the same mitziyut, it's the same reality. Yes, we are but nothing. Nothing. And Hashem is everything. But what are you focusing on? Baal Shem Tov comes in and shifts the focus and saying, it's true, man is small, he's nothing, but that's not gonna make someone wake up in the morning and say, oh, I'm so lucky that a little, like, that little nothing me has a chance to do nothing, because I'm nothing, right? You put the focus on how big HaKadosh Baruch Hu is, and the game has changed. ולכאורה יש מקום לשאול, וכי הבריאה משתנתה בימי הבעל שם טוב, עד שנעשה שינוי בנפשס? Let's ask. The question is, did creation really change in the time of the Baal Shem Tov? That neshamas became different? Are we talking about like a different time of creation, that there's different souls? So we just established that it was the focus that was changed. It's not necessarily the people, but it's the focus on what the avoda is focusing on. Hare medubar al dorot ikvim, ikvus ad mashicha. ואיתה בחזל שהדורות יולדים ומתמעטים. ומה מקום במצב כזה לדיבורים בגדלוס המוחים? So listen to what he says. It's very interesting. He says, usually we always know we're considered like the last, like the heel, right? The ikvus of the Shiva. You've heard this story so many times. We're like the heel generation. The lower, the lower. So if we're like the lowest of generations, so how could we start talking about such bigger things? You know, speaking about Shiflus Adam, how small man is, would be more shayach to the generation that's considered on the heels. But he's asking a question. He's saying, you're talking about a healed generation, but now you're talking about such high things, like the Gadlut HaBoreh. It doesn't add up. The generations are getting smaller, and they're getting further, and they're getting lower. You have to speak in lower language, not in higher language. So he says like this, Lifnei Ora Baal Shem Tov. Ten Hucha Ledaber Me'ora Shem Mashiach, Yichud Kud Shabrichu Shintayim. Azai Haya Adibur Ala Ikvim, Ala Akevot, Al Miut Ador, Al Kach Shemunachim Balo Lishma. Before the letter of the Baal Shem Tov, before Mashiach was spoken about, who spoke about Mashiach? No one spoke about Mashiach. And if they did, it was such a far-fetched concept, it had nothing to do with anything that anyone could imagine. It could be any realm of possibility, A, that it could happen in my time, or that I could have any shayachut to the concept of Mashiach. And Baal Shem Tov comes, reveals to us that he met Mashiach in the higher chambers, and he asked him, when are you coming? He told him, Sheyafutsu Mayinasecha Futsa, when your wellsprings are blasted out into the world. No one spoke like this. So he says, Beram Ora Baal Shem Tov HaKadosh, who is not a tzus Ora Geula HaKayemet, Umushreshet Be'omek Metzius Yisrael. The light of the Baal Shem Tov is a sparkle, it's a shining of the light of redemption, which exists and is rooted in the depth of our metzius as people. Meaning that you and I, even though there are things we can't relate to, just because you can't relate to something, it doesn't mean that it's not part of you. And that's a very important point to make. Just because you cannot truly find the words that can describe your personal connection to something, Baal Shem Tov says, I'm not willing to say that that means that you have no shaychus. So the concept of Mashiach, you can understand, like, we see what it looks like now. It doesn't probably didn't look that different back then. But imagine Jews here walking around here, like, before the Baal Shem Tov came on the scene, you're talking about Mashiach. Look at this place looks like. Look at this country. Look at this weather. Oh, Mashiach, what are you talking about? Baal Shem Tov is introducing the concept that even though you can't necessarily feel something, you need a tzaddik to believe in you, that he could see it in you. That he could see it in you, and he can schlep it out of you, he could draw it out of you. Because it's mushrash mecha. Whether you feel it or not, redemption is something that is rooted inside of you. Now this is the beef, this is the meat, this is the Romanian, if you will, of this piece. Ve'al kein Baal Shem Tov HaKadosh lo shina klum. Listen to this. The Baal Shem Tov didn't change anything. But what did he do? Ki im hosif teva achat. The Baal Shem Tov adds one word to our lexicon. The Baal Shem Tov adds one crucial word that we must place in our language, the way we talk about ourselves, the way we refer to anything in Avodas Hashem, and the way we refer to our relationships with everything that's in our lives. And what's that word that the Baal Shem Tov adds, kivyachol, into our lives? Adayin. What's Adayin? Adayin is the game changer.
Yet.
Not yet. Adayin is chassidut. Adayin is the chiddush of the Baal Shem Tov. Plug in the word adayin to any sentence that you've used before defining your own self-persecution. I don't have shalom bayis. Yet. I don't know how to daven. Yet. I don't know how to really learn. Before the Baal Shem Tov, period. After the Baal Shem Tov, I don't know how to learn yet. This word adayin is the, this is it. This is the game changer. When you plug in the word adayin to your consciousness, like we're all here, we have a lot of things we're davening for, we're hoping, we're praying, it happens. You know how it begins to happen? Jonah, Menachem, the Chevra saying last night, I don't know my purpose, I don't know what I'm doing. I don't know my thing yet. I don't know my purpose yet. So what does that mean? What does the word yet bring to the table? But when you say, I don't know what I'm doing, I don't know what I'm doing here yet. I don't know I don't know what the point of being a firm Jew is yet. I don't yet know. But it's incredible how when you instill that word into your, not just the way we speak, which is actually very important. It's very important to put it in the way that we speak, to insert that word into all those moments we catch ourselves, and the non-yet moments, you put that in there, it's a game changer. And that starts to seep in deep down inside. I don't know how to be the best father I could be, and it kills me. Stop the word, and it kills me, and put in the word, I don't know how I could be the father that I want to be yet. I don't yet know how to be the father I want to be. And then you give yourself a chance. And that's all the Baal Shem Tov wanted, was for you and I to give ourselves a chance. We kill ourselves. We shech ourselves. It's not enough. The world is so hard on us. We are our greatest slave drivers. You put in the word adayin, besemcha, into this lexicon, and you have friends look at each other with adayin eyes. That's how you build a shul. That's how you build a community. That's how you build Am Yisrael, with eyes of adayin. I've seen it in Rabbi Shechter's community in Chicago, with all the chevra there that have been growing so much because they have adayin eyes on them every Shabbos, every day. Our leaders have to be people of adayin leaders. They look at you, and they see you. You could be driving your car on Shabbos, chas v'shalom, whatever it is. And not the adayin, like I'm judging you, oh, you're not from yet. But no, you. Shabbos hasn't reached you. Yet, adayin. This is the whole chiddush Baal Shem Tov. I learned this piece, I was shaking. I was shaking because people always ask, so what is it the Baal Shem Tov did? He put a focus on tefillah? I'm sure people dabbled before the Baal Shem Tov. Well, he put a focus on dancing? I even think people danced before the Baal Shem Tov. Could be, right? What, Liba Simcha? There are probably some happy Jews in the world. But as a hashkafa, as like a complete shift in focus and consciousness, this paragraph seems to, for me personally speaking, I've given myself so much more room to breathe, not to be lenient on things. This adayin doesn't patter you, doesn't say, oh, I didn't do it yet. Maybe one, no. Suddenly, because I think that I have a chance, I try even harder. But I usually don't even try hard on things because I didn't insert the adayin into my vocabulary. So now look how we talk. Adayin lo bati el hashlemos. I didn't reach completion yet. Yeah, I haven't yet reached my shlemos. Adayin lo bati lishma. I don't know how to be a Jew that serves Hashem lishma, or I don't yet know how to Jew who manish davens and learns lishma. Ve'omed ani levo lezeh, but I'm coming to it. She'arei ani ma'amin be'mun ashrei abiyas ha'mashiach. ואף על פי שיתממן כל זה אחר כלה בכל יום שיבוא. ואמונה זו, this אמונה of believing in Mashiach, שהיא מיסודי הדת, it's the foundation of our religion. סוד משמעותה היא האמונה בקדוש ישראל אשר תסגל על ידי משיח. He says something so powerful here. When you say you believe in Mashiach, you know what you're basically saying? You say, I don't yet know how holy and precious it is to be a Jew. But I know that it's coming. I know that I don't yet know, I know that it's coming. זה חטא מרדלים, שנכנסו לארץ ישראל, והלכו על פי שכלם והסתכלותם. This is exactly the problem of the Meraglim. What did the Meraglim bring to the world, essentially? What did they bring to the world? Huh? Yeah. Churban Beis HaMikdash. They come back, they report what they report. We start crying. We start crying. Why do we start crying? Because we didn't have the word adayin in our words. Because we think this is it. What they saw, this is it. They bring Tisha B'Av. They bring the destruction of the world, basically. And this was their mistake. Sharei Hashem Yitbarach Amar Sheharetz Tova Vegam Shama Mipin Moshe. They heard from Hashem, they heard from Moshe Rabbeinu, the land is good. Ve'af al pichen, nonetheless, histaklu be'ofen shel pchitut u'shlidin. They looked at the land negatively and with like a minus instead of the possibility of a plus. Ki'ilu ha'meravim hayu medavim be'ofen zeh shel adayim. If the spies would have used the word adayim in their vocabulary, הרי כל משמעות הסתכלותם בדבריהם הייתה אחרת. Then the way that they would look at what they look at and the way they would perceive what they would see would be in a ruach of adayim. And they wouldn't come back and report the way they reported. Like you have many people that come to Eretz Yisrael for a visit, they see certain things that, yeah, it doesn't look like, maybe the Baal Shem Tov would choose, probably Baal Shem Tov would choose to hang out with them, but other, you know, heilige frum stark people wouldn't hang out with. And they come back and report, Eretz Yisrael is not ready. No, it's not, we have to stay in our, we're regarded and protected. That's meraglim. That is mamish meraglim talk. In order for us to look at Eretz Yisrael and to bring the light of Eretz Yisrael to the world, we have to continue with the adayim beauty, the way we have to look at everybody over there, and in the whole world, but dafka there. הרי כל משמעות הסתכלותם בדבריהם הייתה אחרת, שהארץ עדיין אינה בשלמות. What were they basically saying? Eretz Yisrael is not a place for us. How about saying, Eretz Yisrael seems to not yet be a place for us when we're looking at it from the outside. But when I look at anything in the inside, the word עדיין brings me closer to everything and to everybody. And especially to all the dreams Hashem has for us. So in the schus of the headquarters of Adayim, because this really is what it was, in the schus of this makam kadosh, which is even, I always say when I'm here, it is by far one of the most mezhibush moments to be saying anything in a place like this, the Amos. Because it's hard to fathom. Like we dive in here, we dance, the Baal Shem Tov sat right over here. The Baal Shem Tov davened to Hashem, he changed heaven and earth from right here. The Baal Shem Tov, the Israel Baal Shem Tov, from here. Right over here is where the headquarters of Adayim came out into the world. Alevai. Alevai, the way we look at our children, our wives, our friends, our leaders. When we look at our leaders, it's easy to ridicule, it's easy to rip leaders. Because they're usually mamish so off. Like if Shlomo said, a rabbi is called rabbi because they're ra, but they get by. A rabbi, right? It's so easy to do that. It's so true, you know? But if we could look at them with eyes of adayim, they're trying their hardest. They're adayim. They are adayim too, but they're on their way too. Halavai, with this chus of the adayim chiddush of the world, this light can be the game changer that we're all hoping, waiting, and praying for, and it begins right here. Yeah.